settle something.
Right?
For sure.
Somebody wins and somebody loses.
Can you take a knee, please?
Oh. I mean, we talked yesterday about not seeing as much playing time.
Yeah.
How are you feeling today? You came in there and your guys have said you lit a spark when you came in.
It's kind of just patient. My time's been cool. Especially being behind two of the guys, how I've been seeing Charles really comfortable in the tournament. And I kind of been situated this all year. I'll play 20 minutes one game, play 5 minutes other game. But that's not whenever I'm given opportunity. I know I work so hard and I have so much confidence in myself that I'm going to provide a spark. And being able to go out there and get a really good spark going and bring positive energy, I thought it was cool.
Taking advantage of that spark, of the momentum, of the energy that you guys had in the second half, how important was that today?
It was huge because you couldn't get really anything going up until that point. Coach put me in, and he was like, find a way to provide a spark. All my teammates knew, because as soon as I went in, he drew up a play for me, and I was able to capitalize on it. But just being able to have the momentum going, and we have like a really amazing fan base out here. And it's really hard to kind of stop the momentum when a really good team has something going and has fans behind them, and it really pays off.
Going to the national championship. How are you feeling?
It's actually crazy. It's really hard to really like it and take everything, because everything moves so fast. Like, everybody, you know what I'm saying, they have 2 days to really watch and look at the game. But we're going to go back, go to sleep, wake up, do a film for like 17 hours, and then look at the plays and everything. But I'm definitely trying to take it a little bit right now, especially in the first week. Having the impact is definitely amazing.
Thank you. Jordan Bovar is obviously a huge part of this team, but Did you guys expect anything like this from him tonight?
We knew Mo was due for a really big game. And he's one of our best players, and being able to go out there and make big time shots, I mean, he's been doing it all year. We just continue to have the confidence going. He wasn't hitting shots in the straight round. But we know, like, a guy who's worked so hard and has so much talent, everything's gonna go the right way eventually. And being a B-side player, he was, it definitely paid off in the second half.
Was that part of the game plan to kind of get him the ball?
Yeah, we definitely were trying to be aggressive. Mo's one of our most aggressive players, being able to call plays for him, and also realizing that we were getting really good looks in the first half, but they weren't falling. Being able to trust him and being able to know that he's going to make the right play and going to start hitting shots with his.
Charles, too, man, he was aggressive the entire game. So, what did you see out of him? And those two kind of carried you, especially like the first 30 minutes.
Yeah, they're definitely two really good players. And when they work so hard to be in situations like this, they're definitely going to take advantage of being able to attack the lane and create shots for themselves. And those are two really good guys. When you got two guys like that leading your team, it's definitely huge.
What did you guys do defensively to change things when everything flipped? You were down 10, and then you took over, man, and forcing turnovers like crazy.
Oh, that kind of goes back to our motto. We're just competitive. We have pride issues. Everybody on the team takes everything personal. And we obviously realized that we weren't able to really, like, get in the groove. But we know that we got here. I say, man, it's a really far, really long road, and being able to be in a situation like this, we couldn't let up. And being able to have X like that, who wasn't having the most amazing game, but also being a dog on defense and leading us and being the person at the front of the court and we looking at him, it definitely got our defense going and it was huge for our success.
Can you reflect on this season? You guys weren't even ranked in January, Now you're going to the national title.
That just kind of proves that our back's been against the wall the entire year. I don't even think we were one of the teams to make the top out of the Big Ten, not only win the Big Ten championship. And then we got all the way up until this point, and then we were the underdog because obviously you want a Cinderella team to win. But those are really good guys. Like the team that we played, they're an amazing team, but we had our backs against the wall, and we just feel like we played better. We got something to prove, and we're kind of excellent.
And how are you guys remaining cool and calm in this environment? I mean, look at this room, look at the arena you just played in.
That just kind of shows who we are as people. We're always going to be ourselves, and we're going to show our individuality, you know what, and being able to take it every day by day and not get too amped up and looking ahead. We easily could have came out here and lost a game if we started thinking about Monday, but being able to take everything day by day and step by step, being able to lock in. It also keeps us cool and composed. We're also excited because we're still 18, 19, 20-year-old kids, and we're definitely still trying to hear everything.
CJ's and Johnny Manziel is tweeting him. Do you have any cool stuff like that?
Yeah, me and Jordan Peele had a little conversation. I think Jordan Peele kind of outdoes Johnny Manziel, but definitely having CJ be able to hit shot and have a conversation with Johnny Manziel is mad props.
That's a burn on
Manziel. I mean, he did just get an Oscar.
Yeah.
He got an Oscar, so I feel like that's a pretty good
Jordan Brinson at halftime, he gave a speech about